Hi, welcome to Kwangjin Fine GMAT, your DIY study guide for the GMAT. I help students to self-study. And for today's video, I will tutor you for free on coordinated geometry. Let's begin the tutoring session. So what are the fundamentals of coordinated geometry? First, everything happens on a coordinated plane. Sometimes the coordinated plane is referred as the rectangular coordinated system in the GMAT. We have the x-axis, which is a horizontal line here, and the y-axis that is a perpendicular vertical line to the x-axis. And the middle point where the x-axis and the y-axis meet is called the origin, which has both the x and y values as zero. A point in the coordinated plane is denoted as bracket xy. The pair of numbers in which x coordinate is the first number and the y coordinate is the second number. Hence, the origin has the xy coordinate of 0, 0. The coordinated plane is divided into four sections, which are called the quadrants. Quadrant 1 begins at the top right that has positive coordinates only. And the numbers for the quadrants are in Roman numerals that increase anti-clockwise. 1, 2, 3, and 4. The first quadrant has both the x and y values positive. The second quadrant has negative x values and positive y values. The third quadrant has both the x and y values negative. And the fourth quadrant is at the bottom of quadrant 1, where x values are positive and y values are negative. If you ask, do we have to know about the quadrant numbers? The answer is yes. You need to memorize it as it appears in the GMAT. This is the actual GMAT official guide, the 2020 question. The graph of the equation xy equals k, where k is less than 0, lies in which two of the quadrants shown above. So you can see that you need to know the concept of quadrants. Let's solve a GMAT level quadrant problem that is around 400 level. Pause the video and try to solve it. The graph of the equation x equals y lies in which of the quadrants shown above? If x and y values are the same, it means both values of x and y have the same positivity. For example, if x is positive, y is positive. And if x is negative, y is negative as well. Which quadrant has both x and y positive? The first quadrant. What about both x and y negative? The third quadrant. Therefore, the answer is B, quadrant 1 and 3. Any line in a coordinated plane can be written as y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of the line and b is the y-intercept of the line. What is y-intercept? It means where the line intercepts or graphs at the y-axis. For example, have a look at this line. What is the y-intercept of the line? It's 2, because the line passes through 2 at the y-axis. So the value of b for this line is 2. What about this line? The y-intercept for this line is 0 because it passes through the origin, or where the value of a y-axis is 0. So the value of b for this line is 0. In fact, any line that goes through the origin has b at 0. So the equation for these lines is y equals mx. Now let us talk about the slope of the line, or m. In a coordinated plane, any line has a slope, whether it is inclining, declining, or flat. A slope of a line can be found by a simple concept of right over wrong. Right means different in the y coordinates, and wrong means different in the x coordinates. How do you find the differences? Well, any line can be drawn with two points in coordinated plane. If you connect a line between two dots, a slope will form. Let's write the coordinate for these two dots as x1, y1, and x2, y2. So the difference in y coordinate is calculated from subtracting the values of y coordinate between the two points, or it is y2 minus y1, and the difference in x coordinates can be calculated by subtracting the values of x coordinates between the two points, or it is x2 minus x1. Let's have a look at this line that goes through the origin. It goes through 0, 0 and 1, 2. So right is subtracting 0 from 2, which is equal to 2, and wrong is subtracting 0 from 1, which is equal to 1. So right over wrong is equal to 2 over 1, which can be simplified to 2. You can subtract the other way around as well between the two points. If you subtract 2 from 0, it is minus 2. And subtracting 1 from 0 is minus 1. Right over 1 is equal to minus 2 over minus 1, which is equal to 2. Hence, it doesn't matter which point you subtract the values from. But be careful not to make the subtraction order. It's either y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 or y1 minus y2 over x1 minus x2. Choose one method over the other. Of course, it is always better to subtract the easy way, like subtracting 0 from 2 rather than 2 from 0. The value of m for this line is 2. What is the y-intercept for the line? It is 0 because it goes through 0 at the y-axis. So the value of b for this line is 0. From the equation y equals mx plus b, the equation of the line can be written as y equals 2x. Simple, right? Once you have a line equation, you can find the other points in the line. For example, what is the value of y when x is equal to 1? It is 2. What is the value of y when x is equal to 2? It is 4, and so on. So you've learned how to calculate the slope of the line, y-intercept, and the equation of the line. Here is another point you need to memorize. If the slope of a line runs like this, the slope or m value is positive. On the other hand, if the slope of the line runs like this, the slope or m value is negative. What about a flat line? The slope is always 0 because it is flat. For a vertical line, the slope does not exist because all vertical lines have one value as 0, but we cannot divide a number by 0. That is why m values for all vertical lines are undefined or have no slope. Make sure you get familiar with the positivity of line slope. Positive for this way and negative for this way. It will help you to shorten time in the exam. Also, remember that for any parallel line, the slope of the lines are the same. For example, if there is a line with a slope of m at minus 5, the parallel line to this line will also have m equal to minus 5. If a line is flat, m value is 0. A parallel line to this line will also be flat and have m value at 0. Let's solve a similar level line problem that is around 500 level. Pause the video and try to solve it. The graph of which of the following equations is a parallel line to line L in the figure above? We know that parallel lines have the same slope or the value of m, so we need to first find the slope of line L in the figure. In order to find the slope of a line, an easy way is to pinpoint two points on a line and find the right over run between these two points. We can select the x-intercept and the y-intercept because they are easy to calculate for right over run. The x-intercept is where the line graphs the x-axis. It is minus 4, 0. The y-intercept is where the line graphs the y-axis. It is 0, 1. Before we solve for the value of slope, can you identify if this line's slope is positive or negative? It's positive because the line runs diagonally this way, so the slope must be positive. Since the run is 4 and the right is 1, the slope is right over run that is equal to 1 over 4. M is equal to 1 over 4. Hence, the slope of the parallel line must be also 1 over 4. But before we rearrange the line equations in the answer choices, can we eliminate certain options? Yes, you can. I mean, this is the GMAT. You must use your reasoning to eliminate options whenever possible. Try to save time whenever you can. Because we have a positive slope, the slope of the parallel line must be positive. What is the positivity of the line equation in option A? If you're not sure, let's rearrange it briefly in the form of y equals mx plus b. From 4y plus x equals 0, rearrange it so that y is on one side of the equation. You can write 4y equals minus x. It means the value of b is 0. But what about the slope? The slope here is negative. In a line equation, it is y equals mx plus b. But if mx is negative, the slope must be negative. Don't calculate it completely for the slope. As soon as you confirm that the slope of this equation is negative, begin to eliminate all similar options. Options A, C, and D can be eliminated with this logical approach. That was neat, now you are solving like a GMAT taker. We are left with the options B and E. Looking at these two equations, which option will have the value of a slope 1 over 4? Obviously, option B can result in 1 over 4. Option E will result in 1 over 2. So the final answer is option B. Notice how I answered the question without going through the full process of the calculations. This is very important in the GMAT. Eliminate answer choices quickly by comparison. And if you can select a correct answer without full calculations, we do by a good logical approach. Before we move on to reviewing other coordinated geometry concepts, let me briefly introduce you on important property about perpendicular lines. Perpendicular means an angle that is 90 degrees to a line. Parallel lines have the same slope, but what happened with the slope of perpendicular lines? The m values of perpendicular lines are negative reciprocals of each other. Let's say a line has a slope of m, then the perpendicular line to this line will have the slope of minus 1 over m. For example, if a line has a slope of 2, the perpendicular line's slope is negative half. Let's solve a similar problem we just solved, but this time we'll solve for the perpendicular line equation. The graph of which of the following equations is a perpendicular line to a line L in the figure above? We have exactly the same line as the previous question we just solved, and we can calculate the slope of 1 over 4 from the x-intercept and y-intercept points. But this time, the question is asking for a perpendicular line equation. The perpendicular line to line L should be negative reciprocal of 1 over 4, that is, negative 4. Quickly scanning the answer choices, we can discover that option A is the correct answer, because rearranging the equation gives us y equals negative 4x. A is the final answer. Okay, so we reviewed the quadrants, y-intercept, slope, positivity of slope, line equations, parallel and perpendicular lines. Now we'll have a look at finding distances between two points on a coordinate plane. To find the distance between two points, let's say point A and B, the formula is the distance equals square root of the difference of x values square plus the difference of y values square. The difference of x values represents the distance of a horizontal line, and the difference of y values represents the distance of a vertical line. Now that we have a horizontal and vertical values between the two points, we can apply the Pythagorean theorem to find the distance between the two points. As you already know, the Pythagorean theorem is used to find the hypotenuse of a triangle, denoted by c squared equals a squared plus b squared. Hence, if you square root of both sides of a Pythagorean theorem formula, we can get the value of the hypotenuse, or in our case, the distance between the two points. Just to memorize and get used to using this distance formula, let me show you how to find the distance between the example of two points on a coordinate plane. Point A is on 2, 3, and point B is on 5, 7. Find the difference between x coordinates and also the difference between the y coordinates. The difference between x coordinate is 5 minus 2, which is equal to 3. The difference between y coordinate is 7 minus 3, which is equal to 4. So to find the distance between the two points, square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared is the answer. Simplifying it, we get square root of 9 plus 16, which is equal to square root of 25. And the answer is 5. The distance between point A and B is 5, or this is the GMAT, so you can save time by noticing a special right triangle. Memorize the special right triangle of 3, 4, 5 and 5, 12, 13. And you can save much time without calculating all the squares and square roots of the Pythagorean theorem. Now that you reviewed finding distance between two points, let's solve a GMAT level problem. Pause the video and try to solve it. In the rectangular coordinate system, which of the distance between following two points are equidistant from the distance between the point 2, 1 and 7, 13? Equidistant means the same distance. First, find the distance between the two points 2, 1 and 7, 13. Note that when you calculate the difference between x values and the difference between y values, that is 7 minus 2 for x distance and 13 minus 1 for y distance, it is 5 for x distance and 12 for y distance. This is exactly the same as the special right triangle length of 5, 12, 13. So we know that the distance between these points is 13. All answer choices have an origin at one point, so it's easy to calculate the distance. Option E is the correct answer, because it is the same value as the special right triangle of length 5, 12, 13. You don't need to calculate it completely if you know the length of the special right triangles, so make sure to memorize them. Save time whenever you can in the GMAT. E is the final answer. In sum, the key takeaways for the coordinate geometry are 1. The quadrants are divided into 4 sections, denoted by quadrants 1, 2, 3, and 4 going anti-clockwise. 2. A line equation in the coordinate plane can be written as y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of the line and b is the y-intercept, or where the line graphed at the y-axis. The slope of the line can be found by right over run, or the difference in the y-coordinates over the difference in the x-coordinates. 3. Memorize the positivity of the slope of a line. When a line runs like this, it is positive. And when it runs like this, it is negative. When the line is flat, the slope is 0. 4. A parallel line has the same slope of another line, and the perpendicular line has the negative reciprocal value of m of the other line. 5. The distance between two points in a coordinate plane can be found using the application of the Pythagorean theorem, or square root of the difference of x values squared plus the difference of y values squared. 6. Memorize the length of special right triangles, such as 3, 4, 5, and 5, 12, 13, to shorten calculation steps when needed. That's it for the fundamental coordinate geometry. And smash the like button if you love this free tutoring session. Also consider subscribing to this amazing channel. And good luck studying for the coordinate geometry.